Hi guys, today something special for you. This green box, as you can see, typical military green, Soviet military green. What is this? It is quite heavy. It has a nice cover made of die-cast aluminium. It has other things to close it. So in the cover you have a screwdriver, by the way, original screwdriver. You have some accessories here. I believe it is bulbs and one little wrench. So what do we have here? We have the Soviet R014D radio crypto modem, serial number 8571. So what is this? I believe it is for transmitting encrypted information through a regular radio. As you can see, you have a set of buttons, rubber buttons, some function keys, it seems, and a set of light bulbs here with numbers. So here you have instructions plate, some power buttons, test buttons, plugs here. This is a regular radio onset plug, as you have on the R105 radio. And this must be the power supply input. By the way, it takes 4.8 volts. It is very, very low for such a device. So here you have two battery box with a space for two batteries, but if I remember, it is empty, but I did receive this a long time ago and I am not sure of that. So I got this item from eBay. Usually it is quite regular that people ask me where I got the items. So it was from German eBay, and it was 40 or 50 euros, if I remember. So it is pretty cheap for such a device, because it is a collectible one. Yes, so it is empty. You have all the things to connect the batteries, the wires. In fact, it is incredible, but I believe this thing is new old stock. I am not sure if it was already used, because you can see here, at least onto the battery wires, there are still the insulating protective thing from factory. These are rubber seals for battery, or rubber stuff for putting under the batteries maybe. This fuse under here. You can see the battery frame. You have to unscrew to put the batteries inside. Of course, the cover is watertight. So, it's quite neat. So, I will put it back in place and I will show you the insides. Because, oh god, it is full of electronics. And not regular Soviet electronics, but high-grade, vintage, pseudo-digital electronics. So really, weird stuff. So excuse me, I have a few screws to remove. As you can see, I could do it pretty fast, but And we will see the awesome contents. So it is complete military quality. It's a military radios. Very, very high quality and very heavy. Everything is in the die-cast metal in it. There we are. So, I have to flip it over if I remember correctly. Yes. Then a little help from the screwdriver and it should pop open. Yes. Okay. So, what do we have? So this is just the battery compartment, nothing interesting. On the side here some power supply stuff it seems. Here also the transformer and the big electronics set is in here. You can see all the wiring here and a complete sandwich of circuit boards. So I'm trying to figure out how I can show you. I have to remove all these screws. Again, more screws. And I'm able to show you the... So there is already photos of it available onto my Flickr. The other way, I will put it back together off camera because if not, it will be a too long video. You can see the boards are starting to release. I have to remove very long screws, two more of them remaining. And here we are. I need not to lose the shots or whatever. So. So on this panel here, you can see the camera here, maybe like this, yes, sorry for the seasickness, okay. So on this panel here, you can guess square packages. What do we have here? We have some amber things, amber colored things. I have no idea what they are. Maybe some kind of a small hybrid modules. Here is just the transistors. This is a glass tube, quartz in a glass tube. Then next layer. Oops. It's okay. So next layer. These are, it seems, corkwood assemblies. With a two sandwich of two PCBs. You can see the connections on the side here. These things are very pretty, but I don't know what they are. Maybe some small toroidal transformers. There are more of them at the bottom layer here. Some desiccant I did put in it. So here we have a little hybrid modules with it contains a few transistor chips connected together. It is the same we have into the Iskra calculator circuit board. I did send such a circuit board with such a package to Dave Jones. It is still in from EEV blog, it is still into his mailbag pile. and he needs to open it someday, and we'll have some of these secrets to explore. So more of them, and after it, it's all behind there. You just have, excuse me, the bulbs and the switches from the front plate. The little mystery box here. Nice toroidal transformer here. And it's almost everything, in fact. So all the magic happens in here. So I am very, very happy with this item because it is not, look at this wiring, seriously. It is really, really neat when you think that it was completely handmade, designed by hand, made by hand. Really, so maybe I can find you a dead code just to give you an idea of when it was made. Oh, I have 1979. So it is really, really, really old. Almost as old as I am. And the overall condition of this thing is really good. They can't complain of the condition. Really. I believe I lost the washer. No, not sure. So, here we are for this. Just the last thing. The case, you can see it is pretty thick. And pretty serious. So, here we are for this item. Maybe in the next video I will try to power it up and see what happens. But if I remember correctly, it doesn't do much. Because it needs to be connected to a radio to do this thing. And it needs to have another similar item maybe at the other end of the radio signal. Not sure at all, and there is very little information about this thing onto the web. It is not very much documented, so it remains a mystery. So really, these little amber things are really nice. You can see the more small diodes here and all the stuff. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye. See you soon.